Hi there. Welcome back to our 101 Ergonomics series with Physioactive. In this video, we present ergonomic tips on how to ergonomically use different kinds of work settings at home to reduce injury, including using the sofa and bed as alternative workspaces. Working in a new environment may present challenges, particularly when that environment is your home. However, it may also provide opportunities to change your posture from time to time, given the options of different settings that can be modified to maximize your comfort and support your overall health, safety, and wellness. Introducing Agus the auditor, a slender guy with the sharpest eyes for details behind his thick-rimmed glasses. He scrutinizes the company's financial records meticulously on his laptop computer every day. As he is a perfectionist, he tends to work overtime most days of the week despite the sharp pains on his neck and the strain in his eyes. This may already sound like a lot to deal with in terms of health issues. However, these pains have been further aggravated due to the work-from-home campaign during the COVID-19 pandemic. When working from home, by far the most important aspect is to set up your workspace properly. Since there are tons of great videos around to illustrate this, we won't go into details in this video. If you are interested, there's a link in the description below from the Wall Street Journal on ergonomic setup of your desk. But let's go back to the basics of ergonomics: proper posture, managing forces, and excessive repetitive motion. So even though your workspace may be set up properly, sitting at your desk for 8 hours a day or more may take a toll on your body as it falls under the category of repetitive motion, as in the case of Agus. To break this repetitive motion, try working from different locations, for instance, the sofa or the bed, with the key ergonomic concepts in mind, of course. This can be summed up with the acronym NEW. N for neutral posture, E for eye and elbow height, and W for work area. For neutral posture, attain a proper posture while performing sitting or standing work. A neutral seated posture should include sitting with the neck straight, shoulders straight down loosely at the sides, lower back supported on the backrest of the furniture, 90 degrees at hips and 90 degrees at the knee, feet flat on the floor or on a footrest. For eye and elbow height, elbows should be at a right angle, wrists straight. Make sure your laptop screen is not too low as not to cause neck strain. For your work area, keep your laptop in the primary work zone. Let's apply this to working from the sofa or bed, which may pose a challenge given that every home is different. Here are some suggestions on how to best do this. When working from the sofa, keep in mind that regardless of your age, health, or flexibility, sinking into a cushy sofa or chair pulls down on your spine and pelvis, causing strain. If your sofa is too low, try to put a cushion under your bottom, or use a sitting wedge to help correct the squidge factor. If you are suffering from sciatica, then a coxie wedge will be even better. Put another cushion in your lower back to provide some lumbar support if you need it, or use the great dorsal back to provide support all round for your back. Don't reach over to use your laptop on the coffee table. In terms of ergonomic crimes, this is one of the big ones. The strain it will put on your lower back will have you reaching for the painkillers quicker than anything. Bring the laptop to you. Balance it on a cushion if you must, being careful that it doesn't overheat. A much better option would be to use a laptop tray table. When working from the bed on your laptop, it is important to be aware of your body's position to help you avoid pain, numbness, fatigue, tingling nerves, headaches, and other unpleasant effects. To support your spine adequately, sit with your back against the wall or headboard of your bed. Place a small pillow or pillows behind the lower back for additional lumbar support. Place another pillow under your knees. You shouldn't feel any inclination to hunch over, slide downwards, or turn sideways. Keeping the laptop screen directly in front of you is important if you want to avoid cracks in your neck and back. Be careful not to slouch. Your elbows should be bent at no more than 90 degrees and your wrists should be straight. It can be helpful to place a 3-ring binder under the laptop on your lap so that it slopes down toward you and makes it more comfortable to keep your elbows and wrists in the correct position. A portable laptop desk or stand can be a valuable resource for computing when you're away from a standard desk. These devices raise the laptop and place it in an angle, an action that serves two purposes. You can avoid bending your neck to see the screen if it's raised to eye level, and the angled position helps to maintain the correct placement of your arms and hands. And as always, don't forget to move regularly. The basic rule is if it hurts when you get up, you've left it too long. So shorten the time between working and the next break. The breaks don't need to be that long. A quick stand and a few paces around the room will do. Also remember, the key is to pay attention to pain. The basic idea is to take small steps to protect your body. It depends on several factors, including an individual's age, bad habits, and even body structure, which is why you need to be as conscientious as possible. And if you feel pain, take that as a signal. Something clearly isn't working. If you are experiencing pain, please contact us or your local physiotherapist as soon as possible before it gets worse. Hopefully, this video will make your work from home experience pain-free. In our next video, we will cover some simple stretches that will help avoid ergonomic injuries. In the meantime, we wish you a healthy and pain-free day.